So you have an order to administer some IV fluids and you need to know how to get that line ready. We're going to talk about that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Today we're preparing medication to be hung through a secondary line through intravenous therapy. We will need our secondary line, our IV solution and medication, labels for our line and our drugs, and an alcohol swab. Before you get started, make sure you've got the correct fluid and that it hasn't expired in order to mix up your medications. Okay, so once your medication is in your dilutant, I've got my label, Diamond Hydronate, 50 milligrams. It's for Mr. Tanner. I mixed it and it's good for 24 hours. Depending on your agency, you may put the actual date and time on there. I've also got my label drawn up. It's dated for today at 8 o'clock, my initials, and I'm going to identify that it's gravel. I'm going to attach that onto this line here. Now with these labels, you do not need to take off all of this plastic. In fact, leave most of it on. Just take off the little piece of plastic at the end here. And that will allow you to just wrap it around and secure it so it's readable. Okay, let's head to the pump. Now in your secondary kit, you got a hanger. We want to put this on in its extended format, not folded up. I see a lot of times it's hung like this, but that actually is not the policy. We want to have this folded out completely. I'm going to take my primary bag now and I'm going to put it on the lower hook because I need to have a significant difference. I believe it's 8 inches from the top of this fluid to the top of my secondary line in order for it to run properly. I'm then going to hang up my secondary medication on the pump. Now to prime my secondary line, I need my alcohol swab. And I'm going to clean the port actually of my primary line, that very first Y connector that is above the pump. So we're going to give that a nice scrub of 15 seconds. But the magic of TV. Nah, we won't go ahead. We'll scrub it. We're going to let that dry. Now I'm going to attach my port here. And if I hold this down lower than my primary bag, the fluid will run. It is running there. So you can see it's starting to fill here in my secondary chamber, and that's good enough. So all I have to do is simply raise it up and it will stop filling. Now this has a protector sheath as well. We're going to take that off. We're going to pull on our blue cap, secure, and insert. Okay. And then all that's left to do is program the pump. We're going to select that this is a new patient. Adult general, yes. Enter patient ID. You can simply hit confirm at this point. I'm going to select channel B because channel B is where my primary fluid is in. So I'm going to select channel B over here. I want guardrail IV fluids, and if you're not sure, you can always press and just look for those. I'm going to go to my menu of F to J because I know I'm looking for IV solution. IV solution was selected. Yes, that is correct. My orders were for 100. I have a 250 ml bag hanging. I always like to give myself time, so I'm going to take off 50. And now down here is where I can set my secondary bag. I have Diamond Hydronate. We can look to see if it's by generic name. I'm going to page down. Diamond Hydronate. I can select it. 50 milligrams and 50 mils. Yes, that's what I have, so I'm going to select this one. 50 milligrams and 50 mils of Diamond Hydrate was selected. Is this correct? Yes. It now just confirms I have Diamond Hydronate, 50 milligrams and 50 mils. It's 1 milligram per mil. I am going to press next to confirm. I would like this to run over You can either set your rate or your duration. So if I say I want it over 30 minutes, it programs the rate. And then I can hit start. All right, now what we should be noticing is that there is in fact drops coming into this chamber and no drops in this chamber because my pump is taking it from the correct bag. That's your secondary bag, all done. Well, that's our lesson for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Give a thumbs up if it was helpful. Comment below and let me know what you think. And if you have some ideas for future videos, put them there as well. Be sure to subscribe. You'll be the first to know when the next video comes out. I've got some other videos populating here that you might be interested in, so enjoy, and until next time, make it a great day.